The internet people, hope you guys are having a good Saturday, or have had so far. It's Sketchbook Saturday, and as you might have seen, I've got sort of the unfortunate task today of having to pay another tribute to another person that left us, this time from the wrestling world. I'm gonna try to keep the energy high, as high as I can today. The subject matter is a little bit, it's kind of a downer, and to just add to that, I've generally had a long Saturday and I'm pretty tired, but I'll try not to let that affect the drawing. Before I get started, I meant to be back on, you know, on Tuesday of this past week, and then I kept pushing it and pushing it and pushing it. I pushed it to Wednesday, and then I thought, you know, I'd do it on New Year's Eve. And by the time I got to that point, I just realized that I probably just needed a break anyway. And I just took the rest of the week off. So I apologize for advertising stream on Tuesday. I don't like doing that and then not delivering on it. I try not to let that happen too often, I will also be, you know, most assuredly, I can guarantee you, I'll be back tomorrow for Simpson Sunday at 4 p.m. Eastern, so you can mark that down if you want. That'll be for show. We're gonna get started in short order here. With, like I said, a bit of artwork that I really kind of wish I didn't have to do today, but I felt, it would be somewhat appropriate. World of professional wrestling lost a man by the name of John Huber, who is probably more commonly known as Brodie Lee. He's known as Luke Harper in WWE, and Brodie Lee on several other companies, including the company he last worked for, which was AEW's All Elite Wrestling. He passed away a couple of days ago, I believe, about a week ago. He was 41 years old, which is no kind of age for anybody to go, let alone, you know, somebody who was ostensibly in the prime of his life and also a husband and father. I'm not going to say I was, his biggest fan or anything like that, but I was a huge fan, but I was an admirer of his work. I thought I always enjoyed his matches, and I always enjoyed, you know, especially the work he was doing in AEW. I thought was pretty damn entertaining. And it's a shame that he seemed to be really well-liked and really fondly admired, and he was most certainly, if you've seen any of wrestling Twitter, any of wrestling Twitch, and any wrestling show this past week, particularly AEW Dynamite, that was a hard one to sit through this past week. You'll know he was loved, and he was loved and respected by pretty much everybody who knew him, worked with him. And I say here often, and unfortunately, I have to say it a little bit too often, but I'm gonna say here often, measure, legacy is best measured by, not the things that somebody leaves behind, but the people. And the best way to honor the memory of people that have left us, say left us, that has kind of a negative connotation, people that we've lost, people that have moved, gone on, have passed on. The best way we have to honor the memory is to make sure that the that their work and their legacy and their actions and the things that they stood for and cared about, to make sure that those things are never ever forgotten. These people live on in the things that we've learned from them. And if that's any indication to go by, Brodie Lee will be missed and remembered for a very long time. So I'm done talking. We'll get started. Forgot to say Happy New Year to all you guys out there. Hope everybody had a good New Year. Limited as it may have had to be. In take some consolation, I think, in knowing that, you know, 2020 is in the rear view, and I sincerely hope we can do some better things with 2021. That's for damn sure. Not quite there. Let's see here.
That's interesting.
Forgive my lack of commentary tonight. Like I said, I'll try to keep the energy up. I can't guarantee that I'll keep the chatter up as much. I will say, when it comes to this sort of portrait drawing, you really have to be willing to, you know, as I often say, you gotta kill your darlings. Really, if something is not looking right, you really gotta be completely willing to just completely erase the whole thing and the whole big part of it and start over. Sharpie kind of comes in handy.
Sharpie or is this one?
It's this one. Probably. Next, we're gonna take a quick break. I know it's a little bit early in the stream for breaking, but we may not be on too much longer. This looks like it's gonna be one that's going to get done relatively quickly. So let me take my break now, and that'll be that. I'll be right back. Don't go away.
we're back. There we go. Probably wasn't that long,
right?
Hopefully.
Okay. Much as I enjoyed that chisel tip effect off of the Sharpie marker, that's not quite gonna work here. So, gotta do a little bit more to that. Thank you. head's not getting in the way here. This actually goes up a little bit farther, but it's going to require some thinner pens, which I will get to. Thank you.
finding that so many of my problems with so many of these art supplies is just not keeping them clean enough. Try to work on that a lot more in the new year, I guess. I won't exactly call that a New Year's resolution. That's a bit small time for a New Year's resolution, I think, anyway. Yeah, these ball points, when it has that skip in the line, it's usually due to a very tiny clog somewhere on the tip of the pen. So, usually a good idea to wipe those off with some regularity. Place this pen yet. Man, that's bad. Alright, fine, you're cut. Thank you.
Done yet.
Thank you.
Okay. I'll leave it at that.
Okay. lost in my own little world there for a minute. It happens sometimes.
Just about done. Just about.
Okay. As always, as ever, thank you all for coming. We appreciate it. I will most certainly be back tomorrow for Simpson Sunday. That'll be tomorrow at 4 p.m. Eastern. And we should be able to get done our usual three Simpsons-related bits of artwork. So hopefully I will see you for that. Beyond that, I don't want to make any concrete promises about this Tuesday, but I think I'll probably be in a better place by then. And if not, just like I always say, if you're not quite sure when I'm going live and when I'm going to be streaming and when I'm going to be posting new artwork, you can follow me. I'm on the social medias. I am Epic Benjamin J on all of the things, Twitter, Instagram, and Twitch. You can follow me on any or all of those things, and you can have a better idea of when I will be going live today, notwithstanding. I know I didn't post anything today. I apologize for that as well. Today is really the exception that proves the rule in a lot of the things that I'm talking about today. I have every intention of streaming on Tuesday, but if I will post something if I am, and if not, you'll know I'm not. And if you're on my Twitch, if you're following me on Twitch or on Twitter, you will get notifications when I am going live, so be sure to do that. I'm going to leave you now to go collapse into a ball on my couch. Thank you, everybody who dropped by, everybody who will be watching this on the replay. I appreciate you guys. I hope you had a happy new year. I hope we can work towards making 2021 a lot better than 2020. Although, you know, one of the best things I did in 2020 was start this stream, so, you know, it was bad, but I tried to make the most of it, and we do what we can. So we're gonna do some more of that this year. More art, more painting, more drawing. Hopefully, very hopefully, some new actual comic book pages that I will be working on this very stream. I sincerely hope to get started with that because it's long overdue, and I think I've run out of excuses at this point. So look forward to that. I will see you guys tomorrow. Until then, never, ever, ever stop making friends through art. Always make friends through art. Rest in peace, John Huber, a.k.a. Brodie Lee, a.k.a. Luke Harper. If you guys are interested, any wrestling fans out there, or anybody who's interested in being a wrestling fan, you could do a lot worse than looking up some of Huber / Brody / Harper's matches. I know they're running a couple of tributes on WWE Network where you'll find him under the name Luke Harper. Watch this past week's episode of AEW Dynamite if you want to see just what kind of impact one man can have on basically an entire company that he worked with, and have a hint of how his passing impacted the greater wrestling industry at large. Is really a lot of very wonderful and heartfelt tributes on that this past week's episode. Definitely worth watching. And Brodie Lee wrestled for basically every major wrestling company in North America. He wrestled for Ring of Honor. He wrestled for Pro Wrestling Guerrilla. He wrestled for Chikara Pro Wrestling. He wrestled several years in WWE under the name Luke Harper, and he finished out his career up until his untimely passing in All Elite Wrestling, where he really kind of came into his own. It would be a tragic loss under any circumstances, but he was really kind of revealing what kind of potential that he had up in, you know, until that was very tragically cut short. I encourage you all to check out his work. He was a great talent, and judging by the tributes and the outpouring of love and support, he will be very sorely missed. Well, rest in peace. Have a good night. Have a good rest of your weekend. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Never, ever, ever stop making friends through art. And until I see you all again, everybody, please remember, stay safe, laugh hard, ride fast, be kind.